journalist here, Alec Massey.
What you see is the intellectual incoherence and bankruptcy of the Scottish Labour Party and so on, a party that hasn't had a meaningful idea in at least a dozen years. You know, Labour haven't really recovered from the shock of losing in 2007, let alone in 2011. You know, it's a party that had this sort of arrogance and complacency to think it swanked around the place speaking as the voice of the people. It turns out that the people actually don't think that the Labour Party represents them. Of course, the SNP is guilty of some of the same mistakes. But, you know, Labour's devolution proposals are utterly incoherent. On the one hand, you know, they say that, well, we need to do something with income tax and so on, but we need to put in a mechanism that says you can only increase income tax.
That's not true.
You can't cut income tax.
That's not true.
So it's partisan as well as being idiotic.
Quick thought from you, Leslie.
The political culture of Scotland is different, actually, from south of the border. And actually, Scots have been voting for your party for the best part of 80 years. And that's distinctly different. And I think a lot of folks south of the border can actually recognise that.
It's not distinctly different from Liverpool and Manchester. It's not distinctly
If I could finish, because Andrew asked me a question.
Between Scotland and England. That's not the difference.
Well, what I'm trying to say is there's a reason we're sitting here today, and it's not just opinion polls. It's not all of the rest of that. The question is, don't you recognise that the Scots want a social democracy and the rest of Britain doesn't?
I don't see the world in that way.
The voting alone.
I think what has happened when people rejected Tory politics across the United Kingdom, in some parts of England, historically, people in the north or whatever voted Labour, and in Scotland they voted Labour too. The SNP afforded people an opportunity to vote for another party to say they were against the Tory party. I don't accept your construction. I can't accept your construction that says that people in Newcastle, Glasgow, Cardiff don't think the same things and believe in the same things and worry about the same things.
Why is Gordon Brown not involved in the Better Together campaign?
He is involved in the Better
Together. No, he does his own thing. He's involved in campaigning against independence, but he's not involved in the Better Together.
No, that's not true. He was actually out doing an
does
event.
Does he speak at Better Together events?
Yes, he was at one last week because we were discussing it yesterday. I'm only saying that because I remember that's the one it was at. He is a powerhouse of ideas in terms of this campaign, as Alistair Darling has been too. And actually, more importantly, of course they are, and more importantly, ordinary people right across the country, beyond parties, are saying they want to have their voice heard in this debate too.
Joanne Lamont, thank you very much. Thank you.